we have, having seen four instructors, here's the fifth one. So we have Dr. Yogendra Pal with us today. So he has done his PhD from Education Technology at IIT Bombay. And he graduated, I think, last year. He's also currently working in IIT Bombay in this IIT Bombay X project. And what he will be talking about is, in the morning we have looked at how we planned the LED, how we planned the LPD and so on. So now he'll tell us some tools, quick tools that you can use to actually create your LEDs. So many of you might find this a very good activity as a post-lunch session, because you'll be learning about tools and you can go back and try them out. Okay, over to Yogendra.
Thank you, sir. So till now you have learned how to write a script, how to create activities and everything. But now I'm going to show you how you can actually create the video. So those who are beginners, I strongly recommend them either to use screencasts or a tabletop video, what I called it. It is recorded with the document camera. So basically, tabletop video is when you write something on a paper and you record that with a camera. I named that tabletop video. Yeah, so you can create a tabletop video by using this kind of device, although I don't use this kind of expensive device. I have created my own versions of these devices. So let's talk about the screencasting. So previously, means 1 year back, if I had to talk about how to create a screencasting or tabletop videos, I have to describe two different processes. But now, so the software is available, and this software is known as OBS Studio, Open Broadcasting Software, and it is available at obsproject.com. Here's the website, and you, as you can see, that this is named as Open Broadcaster Software. So basically it is meant for broadcasting yourself rather than to create screencasts or to record tabletop videos. But it is configurable and it is extremely useful if you want to create any kind of educational video. So today I'm going to demonstrate how to use this, and it's very easy. So here I have OBS Studio. And it has a very simple interface. So when first I will talk about how to record screencasts. So it has this scened box. You can see scenes. So you can create multiple scenes. But let's not complex the software. Then in each scene you can have multiple sources. So you can see this source box here. Okay. Because I want to create a screencast, correct? In order to create a screencast, I want to record my display. Exactly. So I have to add a source that can record my computer screen, correct? So here, when you will click on plus sign, you will see there are many sources, correct? And that's the beauty of the software. So here, one is says display capture. That means you can capture any display that is connected to your system, and currently there are two displays attached to my laptop. So when I'll add this display capture, you can also give it a name. So let's give it a name, screen, and say okay. So you'll see this. So what it is showing? It is showing the screen, my screen. So my screen has OBS, okay, and because it is recording that, it is seen recursively. So at present it has only display 0. So if you have multiple monitors or multiple source attached to your laptop, then you will see multiple display. So it also allow me to make my laptop as a control machine by not recording it, but using it to control all the activities and recording some other display. So let's record this one, and it also give you opportunity to capture the cursor in the video or not. So I am saying that I want to capture the cursor, and I will say okay. On this black screen, you will see the exact output that you will get after recording it. So you can now see what you are recording. Right? This facility is not available in many other proprietary softwares also. So when you have decided what do you want to record, It's simple to record by simply saying that you want to record something. So there's a button that says start recording, click on that and recording is started. So this button is now says stop recording, correct? Let me minimize this. Now it is recording all the activities whatever I am doing. So at present I am at OBS Studio website. Now I'll move to TechSmith website. Let's move to Amazon, Learn by Watch, my Gmail, some YouTube channel. So there's enough activity I have done on the screen. Now I want to stop the recording, correct? So I'll click on stop recording and that's all. I have created my first screencast. So if I have converted my system as a control, means I want to display what is being recorded and recording some other display, then I can actually see what is being recorded. So let's see where's the recording. You have to go to file, click on show recordings, and your recording will be here on the folder. Yeah, it's here. And you can also see it is also recording the cursor, correct? So this is how you'll record your first screencast with this software. This is a open source software. You can use it without any problem, means you do not need to buy license and other things. Yes. So this was the basic use of this software. So here's what I did. I recorded the screen, correct? And as you can see, while I am recording the screen, I am seeing this recursive screen. I don't want to do that. Sometimes I know what I want to record. For example, I want to record the this Explorer, Chrome screen. When I know what I want to record, then I do not need to select the display capture. Instead, what I need to do, I'll first remove that source. I'll add a new source and I'll say that I want to record the window capture. Rather than display capture, I want to record a window. And good thing is that you can't, you can select multiple windows on a single recording. This facility is also not available in many proprietary softwares. So let's say I'll record a Chrome screen. So it is optional to write a name. And now I have all the whatever windows are open on my system. They are displayed here. I can select any one of them. So I will select the Chrome. I want to capture the cursor or not, it's up to me. I want to capture the cursor, so I am selecting this and say OK. That's all. Now you don't see the recursive screen. What you see? You see the window, the Chrome window that I want to record it. And similarly, I will open some other software. So I will open this everything. It's a software. And without minimizing that, what I'll do, I will record one more screen. So I'll say window capture again because I want to record that too. And now I'll select another window that says everything. This is a software and say OK. Correct? Now I want to resize either one of them or both of them. It's up to you how you want to use this. So it saves a lot of editing time. You can put the content exactly where you want to put them during the production time. But here you can put them before you start recording, correct? So let me make it like this and this one like this. And now I'll go to this everything window. And what I'll do, rather than resizing it there, I will resize it here. I'll arrange it as per my requirement. Got it? Now I can start recording and that's all. Now whatever activity I will do, even without minimizing that because it's not recording this particular screen, OBS Studio screen now. So I can search anything here. Basically, I'm doing some activity here. Similarly, I can do some activity on this window, and everything is being recorded. And when I am happy with my output, I will say stop recording, and recording is now available at a particular place. Okay, it's here.
And that's all. Now whatever activity I will do, even without minimizing that, because it's not recording.
So I am recording two separate windows. You can record multiple windows without minimizing one and opening other, correct? This is what we generally do. Those who have created screencasts, they know when they want to work, show how to work on two different windows or two different softwares in the same video, then they have to minimize one, open other. This work is not required, correct? Let's now see one more advanced use of OBS Studio. So what I want to do, most of the teacher wants to do that. I want to record my screen as well as my face on the video, correct? As I already told you that there are sources and you can add multiple sources. So let's add one more source and see what's the possibility here. So there's a possibility to add video capture device. Most of the laptops now have the default camera, and you can buy another camera. I recommend you what you should buy. So let me select the video capture device and say okay. Now it's recording my face because it's using the default camera. So at present I have only one camera. If I would have multiple cameras attached to my system, then I could have recorded all of them together. You can configure the quality of the video, and I am selecting the default values and say okay. Now I can resize it and place it anywhere on the screen. So I believe now you get the idea, correct? So this is how you can set your screen, and when you say start recording, you are recording this without any editing software, without any post production and anything else, correct? Let's stop it and see how it looks.
You are recording this without any editing software, without any post production and anything else. Correct? Let's stop.
Okay, so those who have done recording, they know how much time it takes. Even if you have recorded everything and edited everything, then you put that video into rendering. And it takes a lot of time, depends on the size and the complexity of the video, correct? But here I am able to create this complex structure without any production cost. So there are several other options in the input source. So let's see. You can also add external audio input capture. So if you want to record the sound from other mics, then you can also add that. Similarly, browser source, if you know exactly you want to show the Wikipedia screen, then you can click on this browser source and type the address there, and it will show the Wikipedia screen inside the software itself, means here only on the screen. Color source, if you want to add some background color, for example, I don't want to show this black color, then I can add a color source and choose a different color and put that somewhere on the screen. You know, display capture, game capture is not useful for you. Image, if you want to show a particular image, for example, a logo or something else, then you can select that and display here. Media sources, it's not useful when you are recording. It's useful only when you are streaming yourself. Text, when you want to show some text like your website URL and some important URLs on the screen, So I think that's all if you want to record a screencast. Okay. Let's now talk about creating a tabletop video. For example, if you are writing on a paper and you want to record that, how will you do that with the help of this software? Yes, sir, please.
Is there anything available after the production of the video? Any editing is available?
Yes, yes, I'll talk about that. Yes, it is possible, yes. Yeah, so what you have to do, you have to click on this plus sign and you have to say audio input capture. That's for the external mic. For example, like this mic, it is connected to a mixer that is then connected to the system and then you want to use that. But if you want to use some other mic, there like the Rode mic, lavalier mics, Zoom H1 mics, there are several mics. If you want to use them, then you have to connect the mics here, and in that case, those mics will be available here. So at present, my system has only one mic, so it is showing only one mic. If it has a camera attached to that, it will show the mic of the camera also. And if you have another mic, then it will show that mic also. In that case, you can configure anything, and the mic settings are available here. File, settings, and audio. So here you will see all the mics that are attached to your system. So at present, it has only this internal Microsoft mic, microphone. Nothing else. So here's my suggestion for you. If you want to record either yourself or, yes sir.
Is there any time limit for recording the video?
No. It's open source software. I record, means I stream myself every day on YouTube and Facebook, and it goes for 1 hour to 1.5 hour, and there is no time limit for
that. The answer is less than 10 minutes.
So I'll suggest you to buy this camera, Logitech C920. It is very popular and very useful. So it can record 1080 pixel quality, means full HD video, and it costs only 10,000 rupees, I believe. Yeah, it's only 10,000 rupees, and now it's on sale, so less than 10,000. This is Logitech C920. So instead of seeing this quality, you will see a better quality. And it is very useful if you want to record some other sources, means it's, I can't move that camera, correct? But you can move that, you can put it somewhere else and record yourself. When you are interviewing some person, you can attach two cameras to your system and point each camera to different person. And this is how you record interview video in low cost. And for the audio quality, I'll suggest you to buy this one, Zoom H1. So it records in the memory card, and it also gives you output to your devices like laptop. So you can directly record your audio with this device, and again you can put it somewhere else. It's not attached to your system, so you can put it anywhere and then capture the audio. So when you want to record the tabletop videos, let me show you an example of tabletop video. So this is a tabletop video.
Basically, an operational amplifier is an active element.
So you can see teacher is writing and we are recording that with the camera. So although we have used different camera, but now this camera is available. So we can improve the production quality in the less amount. Means it's only 9,000 or 10,000 rupees camera. So what you have to do, you have to connect this, select the source. Now you know how to select the video capture. Correct? Then you have to arrange that camera somewhere on top of your paper and record this. That's all. So here you can see we have wasted half of the screen. Can anyone tell me why we have done that? No. The actually problem is that screen size is 16:9. The ratio of the screen is 16:9, but we have only A4 size paper available with us. Correct? So we can't do that. So what I did in the second version, I improved that. So I really.
जो communication में use होती हैं, उनके बारे में बात करेंगे.
So now you can see.
सबसे पहली property है duality.
Whole screen is covered with the duality paper only.
Duality property आपको बताती है. How
I have done that?
Transform of XT.
Or how will you do?
Is represented by the XF.
So A4 is already landscape ना. When you are recording A4, recording in landscape mode, correct? No, if I'll increase, it will stretch. It's not stretched, correct?
Yeah.
paper size, but from, no, no, moving the camera will not work anyhow. Large carry, yeah, but the paper size is fixed, na? How will change the paper size? No, video edit, in video editing, if it would have possible, I would have done that in my first video. off? No, then I have to upload it in 16 by 9. Currently, you are viewing it at in 16 by 9 ratio, correct? So let's not waste the time. What I did, I went to the paper mart, buy the whole A size paper, and cut it into 16 inch by 9 inch, and this is how we are using that.
Can I use my mobile camera?
Yes, 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 absolutely. But there is some, yes, you can use that, but there are some problems with the mobile camera. What I have seen, when you record with the mobile camera, audio is generally not synchronized with the video.
I have made a video
using mobile. Then you must have a good mobile. Which company? MI, oh, then it's good. I have done the same with the MI camera. It didn't work out, but it's good if it works out in your case. Any other question? Okay, so let's move to other part. That's the editing portion. So sometimes editing is not required. So currently what we did is we put all the elements in the screen, and if teacher knows what to teach and he has planned, then editing is not required. So 20% of our videos do not require any editing. But for the 80% videos, we require editing, and for that we use OpenShot video editor. It's a linear video editor. If you have used any video editor, then you can easily use that. The good thing about this is that it uses Blender's library. So this means that if you have any 3D model built in Blender, then you can directly import that and use it here. Let me show you the OpenShot video editor. It will take some time. I'll show you the quality of Zoom H1. That's written on the Learn by Watch is my YouTube channel. It has 20% of videos that we create. So we create a whole bunch of videos, and we put some of our videos here on our channel so that students can see the quality, and they can decide whether they want to go ahead with the purchasing and all. So let me show you the audio of audio quality of Zoom H1.
क्लास में टीचर जो भी पढ़ाते हैं, अगर उस सभी के नोट्स बनाने लग जाते हैं तो टॉपिक समझ में नहीं आता, और अगर सिर्फ समझने में लग जाते हैं तो कई पॉइंट्स घर आते आते भूल जाते हैं और ठीक से रिवीजन नहीं कर पाते। नमस्कार, मेरा नाम है योगेंद्र पाल, और इस वीडियो में आप सीखेंगे कि क्लास में नोट्स कैसे बनाएं जिससे इन दोनों परिस्थितियों को बैलेंस किया जा सके। एक टीचर क्लास में जो भी पढ़ाते हैं।
So this is the quality that you'll get with the Zoom H1 mic and some voice modulation. So let's now talk about the OpenShot video editor. Okay. It's very easy to use. This is the screen, and there are some tracks. The idea is that whatever clip will be on top, that will be visible. Correct? So you have to import some videos. Let me import the video that we have just recorded. When you want to edit it, drag it to one of the track. And you can zoom it from here. you can't edit it unless you see the audio. Where is the audio? That helps you to decide. Okay, by using this you can see the waveform. So the waveform is actually displaying your audio. So when you are recording, sometimes you stop, you pause, then you start again, and you don't want to give that video to your students. So you have to edit the video. So here you have this facility in the software that you can see the waveforms that help you to recognize where you did not spoke at all, and then you will go there. So for example, if I want to remove this portion from here to here, what I have to do, I'll have to go to the starting point, then I'll say slice, right click on that particular portion and say slice, and I'll say keep both sides, right? I can later decide whether to remove one or not, but let's say that I want to keep both sides and slice it down. Now I have two videos, okay? Again, I'll click on display and show waveform. Now I'll go to another point and I'll again slice it. Select the portion, delete it and bring it here to the starting point. This is how you do the editing in this software. So generally for the beginners, I suggest only to remove the unwanted portion. Don't do anything else, okay? So this portion, I call it cleaning the video. So the unwanted portion or the where teacher has gone wrong, you have to remove this with this technique. And once you are done, you will export the video. Export video. It will show you some of the formats. So MP4 is the most popular one, although you can select any one of these, and you have to click on export video. I'm not click on that because it will take a lot of time. So this is how you will do recording and editing. So let us say when you have this, okay, let me tell you everything. So you have to use OBS project or OBS software to record the videos. Does not really matter whether you want to record a tabletop video or screencasts. If you are using the camera, make sure that you are using exactly this camera, Logitech C290, because it removes many things. Means if you will record with the external camera like this, then you will have two clips. One is your screencast portion and a video that will come separately. Then you have to process that and arrange that somewhere in the editing software, and then you have to do lot of things, okay? So if you don't want to waste your time in that, bring it. Then if you want to record the audio, this is the audio device that you should use. There are many other devices, but they are costly, so I don't recommend them. So if you want to, if you have budget, you can go with the Rode mic. For the editing, I use OpenShot. You can also do the same. So let us say that with these softwares and with these techniques, you have the video, okay? Now you want to deliver it. How will you give it to your student? Many teacher uses WhatsApp, correct? But you can't track whether they have watched it or not. Even if they have watched it, how much portion have they watched it? If they are faking it or not, you don't know, correct? So what I do, I use a software, basically a LMS, that is known as WP LMS. So you do not need to write it WP LMS because you have to buy it. It's not open source. You can use Moodle if you want to go with the free versions. Otherwise, you can simply use the WordPress, not the WP LMS, correct? All the features that I am going to tell you are also available in WordPress if you know how to work on that. So this is Learn by Watch website, And this is how WP-LMS looks. So I put most of my videos on Vimeo, not on YouTube. Okay, Vimeo. You know about Vimeo? I put most of my videos on Vimeo. Then I arrange them here. So most of our videos are available on Vimeo, and then I bring them here on WP-LMS, WordPress basically. And on WordPress, I use this special plugin. Let me show you that. This is the important part. So the plugin is made by h5p.org. Some of you have heard about it. If you are not using it, start using it. It will help you. So H5P plugin is available for Moodle, WordPress and Drupal. So if you are using Moodle, you can use the H5P plugin. It allows you to embed the activities inside the videos. Let me show you one of the examples. Let me show you the interactive video. So the video can be hosted on Vimeo or YouTube. It works with both the services. Once the video is there, the plugin allows you to bring the video in your system and add some elements to it. So here we will see some examples. As you can see, it is available for WordPress, Moodle and Drupal, and it's very easy. If you know how to work on MS Word, you can work with this plugin. And it is also showing that in a video, inside a video, what activities you can embed. Inside a video, you can embed a multiple choice question with one or more correct answers, fill in the blank question, drag and drop question, interactive summaries, single choice question, mark the word activities, drop and drag, images, tables, labels, text and links. I think this is sufficient for most of our work. Right? It also allows you to jump to a particular time. So whenever one of this activity will come, you can decide whether to pause the video or not. So it will pause the video, and if a student will give wrong answer, you can set the timeline on the video where to jump the studio. So if he has given the correct answer, you might jump him to the next topic rather than giving the explanation on why it was wrong and all. So should I play it? See, as you can see, when it is playing the video, we can see one activity here. When you click on it, it will show you some text. And it's optional, it's not pausing the video. The video is playing, it will show, and it will disappear after some time. See? A student can also decide the playback rate of the video, which is not available in default embedded YouTube or Vimeo videos. And whenever there is activity, you can see the sign, these small symbols. Can you see it? This blue one. Similarly, a multiple choice question is here. Video is not paused by default. So teacher has decided not to pause the video, but a student can still attempt it by clicking on it. So when they will click on it, this will appear in a beautiful way, and they can select what's that. Okay. Similarly, it has many activities. So this highlight the ingredients that have been added so far. We have to select the words. So strawberries, milk. So this is how they get the feedback. And you can also decide to add one more button, whether to bring them back to watch that particular portion or not. So because of the slow internet speed, I am not able to show you this to you, but you can see it. So this is the fill in the blanks activity. This is how they'll get feedback. This is a drag and drop quiz. So this animation is not visible, but I think you get the idea, correct? So there are some tips, and finally you can give them this. I like this summary. So what's the correct sequence of doing something? So a student has to do this. So they immediately get the feedback, and this is what you get with the H5P. This facility is not available in many proprietary services, and even if it is available, it's not available in the beautiful way. Either the quiz comes below the video, or it comes very poorly with the text and bad graphics. But here it is very good, comes with the animation, gives immediate feedback, and it also records the activities that you can directly import to any tin can supported LMS. So that's all from my side. If you have any question, please ask. That I wanted to show you, but somehow it is not working. So I can't show it right now, but it's very easy. It's very easy. If you can work with the MS Word, you can work with that also. So videos are available either on YouTube or Vimeo. Okay. Then when you install this plugin, you have to create one H5P. When you say that and you go to this, you, for example, you like this example, this is interactive video. So what you do, you download this. There's an option to download it. When you download it and you have to upload it on your system, once it is uploaded, this category is available on your system. Means you can create interactive videos now once it is available on your system. So it gives you very beautiful editor, allow you to put multiple choice question in between, allow you to check whether to continue or pause, like this. So if you want to see some of the videos, means on how H5P and all works, I have a YouTube channel known as ET Mantra. You can go to the channel, and I keep uploading videos there. And if you do not find any video there, just send me an email. So this is ET Mantra channel, and you find lots of videos on how to embed technology in classroom or online education and all. You can also write down my email address and WhatsApp number, and you can send your queries to me. I will be happy to answer your queries.
Okay, so while you are taking down Yogendra Pal's details, let me just give you 1 minute on his PhD topic. So he worked with me on teaching programming to Hindi medium learners. So if any of you have learners who are Hindi, Marathi, whatever vernacular, and you want ideas on, you know, what you should put into your videos to ensure that your learners are able to not just comprehend but also to learn the English language, that's another topic on which he is a good person to consult with. Thanks, Yogi.
Thank you very much.
Okay, so in spite of these software gyans that Yogi gave, let me ask Yogi a simple question. How much time will still a person take to create a 10-minute video right from planning? So how much time do you take? So you have he has around 3,200 videos till now. So let's say a 5-minute educational video related to a computer science. Let's say you are teaching recursion to a student. Now to teach recursion to the student right from planning till production, let's say a 5-minute video, how much time will you take?
So if I know my subject, so I take 6 hours to record 1 hour video. That's my time. Okay, that includes editing and production time also. Okay. So but few teachers who come to me to make videos, for a 5 or 10 minutes video from planning to production, they take whole day. And they do not edit the videos. They sit with my team and the team edit the videos. So for 5 or 10 minutes video, even if you know the topic
for first or two, first or for first five videos, you need almost whole day to from planning to production.
And okay, so with an expert like Yogi saying that you need all, he needs almost 1:6. Now imagine you start creating your own videos for a course.